And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a couple of desks for my daughters. And what we're going to do is we're going to build a computer into those desks. And they know that we're building desks, but they don't know that I'm going to put a computer inside the desk. But we're also going to do some fun stuff with the top of the desk. We're going to put some crushed shell down and then put some epoxy over top of it. And so it'll kind of give it a really sturdy finish, and it'll be pretty much protected against all the spills and stuff that they'll probably do. So anyway, it should be kind of a fun little project. I already got started a little bit, so I'll show you what I've got so far. Okay, so this piece here is 3/4 inch MDF. I got it at Home Depot. I bought a full 4x8 sheet, but I had the guys at Home Depot rip it for me at 30 inches. I did that mostly because if you've tried to manhandle an sheet of MDF by yourself, you know it's not a picnic. It's pretty heavy stuff. But I got it because it's super flat and it isn't very prone to warp or, you know, unless you get it wet. But anyway, it's pretty straightforward. These are oak strips. They are 3/4 inch by 1.5. And you can buy them in several different lengths at Home Depot. What I bought was I bought 4 8-foot lengths, and then I use this is a side piece, so we've got one of the 8-foot lengths going this way and that way, and then another one going that way and this way. So that way I don't have to have any seams or anything, and I can still have my full length. So this is 48 inches long, and it's 30 inches wide, and then this will be the front of the desk, and then this will be the back of the desk. And I'm going to build, you know, kind of some shelves here to hide the computer components. I'm going to put the computer components actually in the back part of the desk so that we have room for drawers and stuff underneath. But all I did so far is I cut these at 45 degrees so that they all line up. So I've got my, you know, my corners here. And then we're gonna just glue them and nail them on. So what I'm using for, got my nailer, and I'm just using some of these. Oh, excuse me. These are, oh, I don't even know how long they are. 1¼ inches, 1½ inches. No, 1¼ inches. So these are 1¼ inch rads, and that is more than I need for this little project, because mostly the glue is going to do its job once it's, you know, attached. Now for the epoxy resin, we decided to go with 3/8 inch depth, so we actually have to elevate this, the board here, a little bit so that the side pieces here are, so I get a 3/8 inch clearance. And the reason I need the 3/8 inch clearance is because we're going to put seashells down, crushed seashell that I bought at I think Joann's, or yeah, Joann's, I think it's like a craft store. And we're going to lay those down. My sister's going to do them in kind of a decorative design, and then we're going to dump epoxy resin over top of it. And when I did the calculations, had my dad help me with the math, but basically 1 gallon of resin will cover about 220 cubic inches, I think is what he said. So if I cut that in half, that's 430 or 60, 400 and I think what he said was 430, so it would have been double that for 2 gallons at 1/2 inch, so it would have been at just under 900 cubic inches. But that, you know, it's not going to be a 1/2 inch, because there's going to be some shell and stuff in there that's going to displace quite a bit of that. But we did decide to go with 3/8 inch depth to buy us just a little bit more, and that should be enough. I don't think the shell is going to come up more than about 1/4 inch. So we should be good there as long as we've got enough to cover it, so we don't have anything, you know, rising to the surface or whatever. Then it'll be that nice glass smooth finish that we're looking for. So I'm gonna soon to be 9 year old and a 5 year old going on 6. So they already play Minecraft and stuff, so it's kind of a fun little thing for them. Plus, I don't mind playing Minecraft with them. We run a little server and everybody connects to it and run around and explore. It's kind of fun. The girls get a kick out of it. That's the only reason we do it anyway. Okay, so you just want to make sure you line up your corners as best you can. Make sure you're right on your marks. Get a nail on that side. So again, we're going to get those lined up just how we want it. Right along this seam. Pinch it in as best we can. Ooh, that didn't go good. Oh, I'm running out of air. It all on the other side. Another one with two nails. I don't know what's doing that. It'll all be buried. So that's better. Oh, except for that time. The only downside is I'm using oak, and oak's pretty hard. So even though everything's working good, if there's a knot or something in the wood where it's going to be a little bit harder than normal, you can end up with those marks anyway. So you can get a better idea. Better. See how it kind of ribboned like that. Now on this one, I could go ahead and mark it, but as long as I'm flush with my pieces here, then we're pretty well good. So I'm just gonna go ahead and glue it, nail it on. Finished the attaching all the pieces. So we're gonna route both the top and bottom, just using just a little angle, just a little round over bit is all. And we're just gonna go all the way around. This is the top part. This will be the top surface. Not gonna be too much. There's a little gap here, and there's a little gap right over there, but not too bad. So I'm gonna just shoot a little bit of this glue in there. And normally I wouldn't want excess glue anywhere on the project, but in this case, I'm actually using it to as a filler, because I don't want the resin to leak out. And because I know that it's going to be covered, we're going to paint a base coat on top of this. I don't need to worry too much, because we're just going to use a latex, and then that'll be all that matters. As long as it's tight enough that the resin doesn't leak through. Alright, just real quick, these are the two desktops. Basically the same right now, and we're gonna get them nice and put the shells on them, and then we're gonna put some epoxy on them. It'll look clean and cool. Okay, so this is just a still shot, a picture of the two desks on the desktops as they're being laid out. My sister did most of the work on the two tops, gluing down the pieces and doing the design itself. Is, you know, pretty straightforward, the process. She basically just added the glue in the design that she wanted, and then added the pieces separately in order to flush out the design. And it worked pretty well. We used some aerosol adhesive to kind of help glue everything down, and once it was, you know, glued down, then we were able to move it around without the pieces shifting, and that was pretty much necessary, because once you start pouring on the epoxy, it would have shifted. So props to my sister for the artwork and the design. Obviously it turned out pretty well, and we'll see those pictures later. Really, really shiny. I'm trying to heat it up a little bit to get the air bubbles out. The blue one, I think the blue one really turned out a lot better, because there wasn't as many air pockets underneath all the little rocks as this one did. But either way, they look pretty sharp. That'll be on the desks. Gotta get all these little air bubbles out. A little bit of flame, not too much, just a little bit. Get too much, it'll catch on fire.